త్రీ సిలిండర్ మార్టిన్ త్రీ త్రో పంప్. త్రీ త్రో, త్రీ టైమ్స్ డిశ్చార్జ్. దట్ ఈస్ దిస్ మార్టిన్ త్రీ త్రో పంప్ ఇస్ ఏ త్రీ సిలిండర్ రెసిప్రోకేటింగ్ పంప్. హియర్ త్రీ సిలిండర్స్, ఈచ్ సిలిండర్ ఆక్యుపైడ్ విత్ ఏ పిస్టన్ అండ్ పిస్టన్ రోడ్. ఆల్ దీస్ ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ అట్ 120 degree క్రాంక్. దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద అట్ 120 degree ఇన్క్లినేషన్ ఈచ్ సిలిండర్ ఈస్ కనెక్టెడ్ విత్ ఏ కామన్ క్రాంక్. Here this is the inlet through which water enters. Here a gauge connected, that is a vacuum gauge. The unit in which is MWS, that is meters of water. That is, we need that the head is in meters of water. It is directly in meters of water. It is from 0 to 10. So atmospheric head in terms of water is 10.3 meters of water. So that is less than that, so it is 0 to 10 meters of water. And here is the suction chamber. Water first enters the suction chamber, from which water enters to first, second and third cylinder. Suppose in when the crank is rotating, at one crank rotating, then in first cylinder suppose there is suction, and the second one that is compressing, and other one discharging. In such a way, suppose the fluid from the suction chamber first enters to the first cylinder, there suction occurs, and at the same time fluid already in the second cylinder that is compressing, and that compressed fluid in the third cylinder that is discharging, and then that goes to the discharge side. Here in the just like in the suction chamber, here is a common discharge line. So water from each cylinder first comes in the delivery side, that is in the discharge line, and from there it passes to the discharge line. Each piston that consists of an inlet valve and exit valve. So in the suction side there inlet valve, and that delivery side that is the delivery valve. Here it is the positive displacement pump. It rotate at almost lower speed, that is less than 500 rpm. But the motor is connected with that motor speed that is greater. So in order to reduce the speed, here a speed reduction device that is used here. So after reducing the speed from the motor, it is connected to the connecting rod. So when we switch on, then it is a positive displacement pump. So first, before starting, we have to open the delivery valve. Then when after opening the delivery valve, then we can directly switch on that green button. Then the water that is start sucking, and then after compressing, it is discharging through this way. Suppose while switch after opening this delivery valve, while switch on, sometimes the water is not discharging. At that time, by closing this delivery end, at that time we are actually applying a back pressure, so that helps to discharge the fluid. And after switch on it, then water motor start and water sucking. Then first water enters in one side, one cylinder, and then it is compressing and discharging in the discharge line. Here the input power. Input power of this pump, that is here for the rotation of this pump, electrical power is supplying. So that in order to find out that electric power, here one energy meter and there is one disc. So we have to note the time for 3 revolution of energy meter disc, or 3 or 5 revolution. Now we are noting the time for 3 revolution. So N by T into 1 by K. This K is the energy meter constant. Here that energy meter constant is 200 revolutions per kilowatt hour. So that we need that is in water. So N by T, we are noting the time for 3 revolution, 3 into corresponding time and 1 by 200. It is revolution per kilowatt hour. So that 1 kilowatt hour, that is suppose 3600 into, that is in kilojoule, we need that is in kilo, that is in water. So kilojoule per second we are converting into joule per second by multiplying 1000. So n by t into 1 by k into 3600 into 1000, that is the input power in water. And then output power of the pump. This output power is, we know that weight of water lifting to a certain height, that is rho g q h. So rho into g into q is the discharge. In order to measure the discharge, here a flow meter is provided here. That is, this is the orifice meter. The pressure is tapped at the upstream side and the downstream side. This discharge flow meter is in meter cube per hour. And then we have to convert that in meter cube per second by dividing it with 3600. Here also, just like in centrifugal pump, here is an equalizer and then one drain plug, high pressure side and a low pressure side. So here the equalizer is using to equalize the pressure in the low pressure and high pressure side. So first, after starting, when the water is flowing, then first to open the low pressure side, and then at that time if there is any air that will come out, and then a continuous flow of water will come. After that you have to close it. Then after that high pressure side we have to open. There also if any air that will come out and a continuous flow of water will come, then close it. Then after that we can take readings here. So by adjusting the valve, this is the delivery valve, we have to conduct this experiment by controlling this delivery valve from maximum opening to minimum opening or minimum to maximum. Then suppose it is fully open, we can note the pressure in the pressure gauge, that we have to convert that into meters of water. Here it is kg per centimeter square and lb per square inch. That is outside reading, that is in kg per centimeter square. We need that value. Here the maximum head is 70 meter. So here the reading is up to 0 to 7 kg per centimeter square. Kg per 7 kg per centimeter square means that is corresponding to that head is 70 meters. So that kg per centimeter square, that is kg per centimeter square, that is the pressure. But we need head. So head h equal to p by rho g. So the p equal to 7 into 9.81, it is in newton, and 10 raised to 4, it is newton per meter square, and density of air 1000, and then g. So that head is in meters of water. So note the head here, and we have to note the time for 3 revolution of energy meter disc also. And then one more thing, here we have to measure the theoretical discharge. In order to measure theoretical discharge, here it is a positive displacement pump, it is a 3 throw pump, so 3 times is the discharge. So 3 LAN by 60, that is the formula, actual formula in the text, but here no speed reduction, speed measuring device. So we have to count the number of strokes. Suppose after switch on it, then when the crank is rotating, you have to place the finger just here, and when the crank is rotating, it touches with the finger, so that you have to count the time for 10 revolution or 20 revolution. 10 times that crank just touches here. You have to note that time using stopwatch, from which we can find the actual theoretical discharge. That is 3 into L is the stroke length. Here the stroke length is 15 centimeter. That is 0.15 meter into area. Area is the pi by 4 into, here the diameter is given, bore, that is 12 centimeter. So 0.12 the whole square. So 3 into L into A into N. Here N is the number of revolutions. So we noted the time for 10 revolution and the corresponding time, from which we can find out the theoretical discharge, that is in meter cube per second. But the actual discharge in that flow meter, it is in meter cube per hour. So divided by 3600, suppose if it is 11 meter cube per hour, 11 divided by 3600, then it is in meter cube per second. Then if you are noting the difference between that theoretical discharge and actual discharge, that is the slip. Then slip always expressing in percentage, so that a percentage slip is equal to Q theoretical minus Q actual divided by Q theoretical into 100. Then here, after noting the time for 3 revolution, we can find that theoretical discharge. And here in the delivery side, an air vessel is provided. In some cases, in air vessels are providing in suction and delivery side, but here in only one air vessel, that is in the delivery side. It is a large cylindrical vessel. It is in the delivery line. That is, in this one, it is the bottom portion, there is a small opening through which during the acceleration time, more quantity of fluid enters, a part of the fluid enters into the air vessel. And the top portion contains compressed air. There is a diaphragm which separates the compressed air and the fluid. When the fluid enters during the acceleration time, it pushes the compressed air. And at the end, when it is nearly, piston is reaching half the revolution, the compressed air, there is a deceleration so that the fluid is, this compressed air pushes the fluid in the delivery line. So that there is a more or less constant discharge is obtained from the delivery side. And here a device that is a safety device. Suppose you forget to open that delivery valve. And suppose you that valve is, suppose it is closed position, and if you switch on it, then at that time, suppose the pressure developing inside the pump is greater than that of the design pressure, then it damages the pump. So as a safety valve is provided. Suppose the pressure developing here is more than that of the design pressure, that is the valve lift against the spring pressure, so that the fluid that is discharging through the safety device, so the pump becomes safer. And after calculating input power and output power and percentage slip, you have to plot a graph. Here it is a positive displacement pump. Here discharge we cannot keep constant, so that we are taking head in the abscess, and in the input power and then efficiency and slip we are noting in the, and also discharge we are taking in the abscess. Abscess, that is head is in the abscess, and then head versus efficiency curve and head versus input power and head versus discharge curve and head versus slip curve. These are the different performance curve you have to plot.